Hello everyone, the Quantum Blue Jay here, back with another video of Phineas, another story too. So, where we left off last time, I believe. I do not exactly remember. So I remember that Bonnie confessed that she liked Alex. And Alex wants Bonnie to leave with him to wherever, like, have her get out of the pizzeria. So, that's where we left off last video, and, yeah, if you're enjoying the series, I would, highly recommend you subscribe, click the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell for future videos. And, yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay. John was waiting for me by my car. I suddenly walked over to my car and got into it. John followed my example and sat in the passenger seat. You're taking a long time. John, I have a request for you. Can you run to your house tomorrow? Okay. Why? Alice will come with me tomorrow, too. I have a feeling that not three people will leave the building tomorrow. I looked at John. Four people will come out of the building. Four? Smile, but didn't answer him. I think I'll understand if he just thinks. Oh no, do you really want to take Bonnie with you? She'll come with me. Do you think the others will let her go? Do you think Christy will let you take her? There will be no problems with Christy, and if there are, it will be enough just to scare her. But I think you're right. Other girls won't let her go with me for anything. If they don't let you go, then you'll steal her, right? Yep. Damn. It seems she simply doesn't want to attack him. Maybe you made a mistake. Put the phone aside, put on speakerphone. No, everything should be fine. She's probably ready for the right moment. Or she doesn't want to. I agree with the fact that you may have made a mistake if she really does not know how to do everything that you said. If she does kill him, then she'll come to us. What did you just say? She'll come to us. There were no sounds on the phone for a while. It even seemed to me that the connection with James was cut off. But as soon as I wanted to hang up, he spoke. Tell me, Ray, what were you thinking about when you made her? I didn't do her. But it doesn't matter what's bothering you. My concern is if Alex guesses that she's not really who she claims to be, then he'll deprive us of a new ally. Yes, you can say that. If nothing happens in the next few days, then she'll come to the collector himself. How would she find him? She knows where he is, unless, of course, he changes his location in the coming days. I have already managed to inform him that she can come to him. I hope you describe the current situation. I don't want people with guns to break into my restaurant and accidentally shoot someone else along with Alex. Collector is very interested in me and her. In this case, we can wait. What to do if Alex's friend? He's not particularly dangerous, so he won't touch him yet. Let's say that he will be a backup plan. Before I get to this, I actually just was talking to Mr. Volt, the author of this novel, and I asked about that, if, like, Molten Freddy still was gonna attempt to kill Alex. So I guess that kinda answers that if she doesn't, she'll go to this collector guy or whatever. Interesting. I drove John to his house. The moment I stopped in front of his house, my phone rang. John didn't say anything. He just nodded and got out of the car. I nodded back and picked up the phone. Thought we were going to have a race, but you just let me win. I don't understand such a venture. Where are you anyway? I'm sorry, dear. I forgot to tell you I'm driving John to his house. Aw, well, okay. You're going to go home or you're going somewhere else? Let's pull out and go anywhere, but if you need something, I can go. Thanks. I want ice cream. Haha, you serious? It couldn't be more serious. You don't want to come back without him. This is actually my house. I don't want to hear anything without ice cream. Okay, I'll be there soon. Love you. And I love you. I hung up and left alone, trying the radio and drove to a nearest store. I want something too. I turned my head to the side and noticed her sitting in the passenger seat. She was looking out the window at the surrounding landscape. Still, she always appears at the most interesting moments. I turned away from her and continued driving. I don't think I can handle anything. But that doesn't mean I don't want anything, does it? Yes, okay, what do you want? I don't know. You don't know? Sometimes I don't know what I want either. And what do you do in such situations? Such situations, I'm valid, so I try to satisfy her needs if it makes me feel better. It's good that you're not alone, right? Yeah, sometimes it's better to be alone. Fiona's low. Alice never worked that night. Her shift ends about 7 p.m., therefore, it's logical that she was tied in the time that we were at the Frey Anime Convention. Alice and I were in the living room watching TV. She was eating her ice cream that I bought her. She bought a lot of ice cream. A lot of ice cream. Probably now the freezer and the refrigerator is filled to the top with very ice cream. After a while, Alice fell asleep with her head on my shoulder. She said that it's very hard for her to fall asleep when I'm not around. Maybe she's really right. Now she fell asleep in just a couple minutes. Alice held my hand and went like a, well, she likes it that way, then I don't mind. There's some kind of animal program on TV, but I didn't really care. Zima came to me and stood up in such a way as not to interfere with me watching TV, but at the same time so that I could see her. A man came to us. He wants to see you, Alex. Really, let him in the house. Tell him I'll be there and warn him not to make any noise. As you wish. Carefully freed myself from Alice's embrace and got up from the sofa. Alice at this time was laying down on the sofa and completely occupied it. At least now she was lying, not sitting. The man sat near the front door and did not leave her. But I recognized him. I'm glad that he was my friend. I walked up to him and stopped a few steps away from him. Wick? Oh, well, this is fun. Mercer. For a while, we looked at each other without emotion. Zima looked from me to Wick in a worried way. Noticing this, I looked at her. Zima, look after Alice. As you wish. She went to Alice, and we continued to stand silently and look at each other. Did you come to me because of work?
No, I won't touch you or your girlfriend.
That's good. Good to see you, John. Shook his hand, now he looked around.
Last time I saw you, you were living in a small apartment. Now you have your own house.
Yes, that apartment is still at my disposal, but it doesn't matter. What do you need?
I have a contract, Mercer, and the agency insisted that I need a partner at least 4 mission levels.
I'm afraid to disappoint you, but I have a level 3 mission.
I know, but I think you're exactly what I need.
I hope you can convince the agency of this, okay? How much is at stake?
$5,500,000. $500,000.
Cool, I want half.
This is my contract, Mercer, not yours.
Okay, I see that what you're getting at. $1,221,543.
This is a suspiciously specific request.
Okay. Cool. What's the contract? We found out that one of the businessmen is doing business with the family.
Everything is simple. Go and eliminate.
Excellent. When do we leave?
Preferably now. We don't know how long this man will stay in Nesford.
Walking through the parking lot behind Wilson, I tried to avoid numerous people. We parked on the fourth floor of this parking lot, and some kind of party going on all four floors. In the middle of the day, and the police apparently don't know about it. Although this parking lot is located near the business district, so I think this noise doesn't bother many people. Wilson, like me, examined all the people, probably so we will never find the right person for us. Though how can we not know some? Remind me why we are constantly running errands for Alex.
You have nothing to do anyway, but at least you'll get some fresh air, some fun, alright.
I'm just wondering why we constantly have to go and do what he's supposed to do.
I have no idea, and to be honest, I somehow don't care. Look real more carefully. That person must have multicolored hair.
Yes, I remember. I think he's up there somewhere. I don't think he is.
Here he is.
Wilson pointed someone to the side. The person we needed was standing surrounded by people and talking to them.
I hope you took the money with you. course, and let's not shoot out or anything like that this time, okay? It doesn't depend on me. We slowly approach this man, but two thugs blocked our way. Wilson says something to him, but they didn't react in any way. I notice that this man we need is in front of us and saying something to his friends. One of the people saying that's them now and came up to us and said something to the dunes. The dunes stopped to stand and let us pass. The man was running at us. You know who I am, don't you? Yes, we, customers. Oh, in that case, snapped his fingers and the people saying that's them left. This is so they don't get in the way. I'm Drake, Drake Baller. And who does not interest me at all? Come on. He walked around several cars and approached one of them. Opened the trunk of the car, we saw a lot of firearms. I have all the best and at low prices. Most of them exchanged glances. Baller, we need... No, I'm Baller. That's what I said, Baller. I'm Ballor, not Ball-or. What? Am I just pronouncing it completely wrong? Okay. I'm just gonna name him Baller. Okay. Oh, I get it. In general, Drake, that's not what we're after. And I understood, you need a cold weapon, right? Then it's over there. He took one step towards the other car, but Wilson blocked his path. Drake, we're from Hunter. Drake's face changed abruptly. He looked over our shoulders and carefully examined the crowd of people having fun. I hope no one was following you. I don't think. Is there a problem? Drake examined the people nearby for a while, then looked at us. Listen, you know who Hunter is and what he does. Yes, we know. In this case, you should understand that if the police somehow find out I'm helping Hunter, then I'm just finished. I have a license to sell guns. Not quite legally obtained license, but still there. There will be no problems with weapons should not occur, but if they find this on me... He went somewhere, and we had no choice but to follow him. Drake took us almost to the very end of the parking lot in two unremarkable cars. There weren't even any people near them. A perfect place to hide something. He went to one of the cars and opened the trunk. There was two cases similar to those in which doctors transport different drugs for operations. Drake opened one of the cases just to show its contents. There were a lot of flasks and various liquids in the case. And what is it? That's why you came! This is the shit Hunter needs. The second case has identical contents. Okay, what's in the flask? Something terrible. He carefully picked up one of the flasks with a colorless liquid and brought it close to us. This is one of the strongest poisons. It kills the victim in just a few minutes. You know how hard it was to get the shit? This is the flask. He returned the flask to a place and simply pointed to another one. This is something for which we can put in jail for a long time. It's a drug. I will not say what and how it turned out to be with me. Why does Hunter need all this? I didn't ask. To be honest, I don't care. Customers dispose of purchases as they want, and they'll take it and leave before cops come with a check or something. Wilson transferred the money to Drake. Drake just said to just close the cars and leave from right away. Having said that, he left. I didn't think Alex was doing something like that. We don't even know what he does with these substances. Even through the music, we heard a shot. Having amused the cases, we carefully began to pass the exit. But Wilson stopped me. Pointing somewhere in the direction of cars, I noticed how people were making way for armed people. Knock knock, Bowler. We come from our show. Surprisingly, John and I got into the bell very easily. It was enough just to steal a window wash and left. Seems to me that a few people pay attention to people with weapons who are climbing higher and higher. Target was approximately on the 34 or 35 floor. These are the last two floors, so we'll find the target anyway.
Mercer, we need to do everything as quietly as possible, but...
But if everything does not go according to plan, then you, Alex, can kill absolutely everyone who is here. Isn't that what you were gonna say?
No, I want to say if everything does not go according to plan, you'll have to get to the main office as soon as possible. The target is there. Just go there and eliminate, then quickly go out.
You said, well, let's go. I wanted to leave the room in which we were hiding, but John caught me in one hand.
What are you doing?
I want to complete a task.
If
First, you need to try to do everything quietly. Don't you think so?
Okay, I hope I didn't wear the suit for nothing. Don't understand how you can run in this. It's uncomfortable to fight in this.
You're the one who specializes in post-combat here. Prefer firearms, okay? Let's just go and talk to the secretary.
You stabbed a guy with a pencil. I'm pretty sure you're fine.
I shined my suit jacket so that the weapon was not visible and followed John out.
We left the room so far, not a single person has been seen. It's even good.
Only now I noticed that John had brought a sack of some documents with him. Hope he knows what he's doing.
I meant that you want to shoot.
Oh, and how I wanted to.
That you'll have a chance if things don't go according to plan.
John went down the hall and I followed him. A couple of people passed by us, but it seems they completely ignored us. When they passed by us, I told them, "Hey, how are you?" John looked at me like he was ready to kill me right now, but he just stopped a little further away from us and started pretending to read something in the documents.
Oh, it's not that bad. I think if we sell a few more apartments by the end of the week, we can fulfill the current plan.
That's all cool, but I have a suggestion.
Really?
Yes, we're selling apartments, downtown, Nick. Terrible memory, just awful.
I looked at John, who was pointing out the papers on his end. I nodded.
Of course, forgive me, I haven't been myself lately.
You must have worked too hard. Please, continue.
Sure, seems to me that we can get additional profit if we pay attention to vacant lots of land near the ocean.
Well, or we can buy unused buildings, or...
Don't listen to him, he's crazy.
We have already thought about such things several times, but the boss does not want to consider it seriously. Maybe you'll get lucky.
Yes, we were heading to him. Is he there?
You better hurry. He'll be there. Here.
The man looked at his watch. For about an hour.
Then don't waste time. Come on, Nick.
Do we even know where to go?
I won't lie. This is our first time on this floor.
Something to be afraid of. Right now, you just need to go straight down the corridor. When you reach the floor, turn right, and then straight to the end, you will run to his door.
You are an accomplice to murder, my buddy.
Thanks. Men and his friends continued on their way while John and I continued ours.
You're a complete idiot, Mercer. What were you thinking?
Calmly, Wick, if we had just walked past everyone without talking to anyone, then maybe they were suspected us of something. I sometimes him nodded to a past an hour, guarded with a smile. No matter, let's just get there and that's it.
We reached the office we needed without any problems.
Along the way, we met several office workers a couple of times, but there were a lot more guards. John came down through the papers he had taken for cover. It looks like he just wants to play this legend to the end. Well, okay.
Our target led us in here after we told the secretary that we had a business offer. Here we sat in front of this man. Just need to get down the shoe a couple of seconds and job's done.
Let's get right to the point. I have an appointment in less than an hour.
Of course.
John went over to the table with the man was sitting and sat down next to him. Several clients have appeared here in their request. Very unusual. We thought we should take a look at this.
John handed him the papers and the man began to look through them.
John turned quickly to me and on to the man. Seems he wants me to do something.
Oh, and I have a little question suggestion. What if?
Shut up, Nick. We don't have much time as it is.
Unless John pointed at his phone. It looks like he sent me something.
He sent a shot to a person just like that.
Yes, thank you. Give me another minute. They have interesting requests.
I leaned against the wall and took out my phone. John sent me a message consisting of the word scout everything.
I opened the profile and literally 20 seconds later I could view the CCTV cameras on this floor.
There were a total of 20 guards on the floor. This is bad. Even a pistol with a silencer will not drown out the noise of the shot to the end.
I sent John a 20 people message. I noticed John put the phone on the edge of the table and looked into it.
Yes, interesting. I think we can satisfy the request. Just need to...
Men's phone man. Please forgive me. This is important call.
The man went to the window. He spoke quite quietly and it seemed there was nothing important profile like. Will show me everything. After I connected to this person's phone, I realized that the protection in his phone is very good. I only had a couple of seconds of stable connection, but it was enough to hear some man tell him there are strangers in the building. Quickly opening the cameras, I saw several guards purposely walking towards us. We have a problem. Naturally, no problems anywhere. The show began the game show then. Oh boy. Okay. Well, anyways, so we met John Wick. I feel like I went through the files, like, whenever I was, like, trying to find, pictures for, like, thumbnails and stuff, and I think I came across John Wick. I just completely disregarded the fact he was gonna be in here. So, it's interesting. I'll give it that. But, yeah. So, we met John Wick. Now there's a shootout here. Where John is, so that's fun. Anyways, as said at the beginning of the video, if you all guys like this series and want to see more, I would highly recommend you click the thumbs up down below, subscribe and click that notification bell for future videos, and I will see you all guys in the next video. Have a good day.